the distinguished manager, Mr. Fuji. And the tag team combination from parts unknown at 277 pounds, Moondog Spot. His partner from Sunset Beach, Hawaii, weighing 267 pounds, the magnificent Morocco. Their opponents from Scotland, weighing 228 pounds, Scott McGee. His partner from Tampa, Florida, at 252 pounds, Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff.
Wow, what a tremendous tag team combination we have here this week in the World Wrestling Federation. Of course, only the best being brought to you through the superstars of the World Wrestling Federation. And Morocco, before this match got underway, looked over and said, I'm going to dedicate a pile driver to you, Adrian.
Did he? You know, he's
in fact, he better watch it. He's not on the receiving end of one himself.
I don't think it'll happen. You have to admit that Paul Orndorff is a super athlete, but also a spoiled athlete. Scott McGee's got the potential, but he still needs the experience, and he's going to get it with Don Morocco.
So you think that Mr. Wonderful is a spoiled athlete?
I think he is, and I know he is. Look at the magnificent run. He is strutting, he is talking, he is walking. He does exactly what he wants in that ring. You know, we're good friends, you know, we used to share an apartment.
Oh, you did?
Yes.
Well, how interesting things become as we go through the realm of realism here in the World Wrestling Federation.
Oh, you would pick up things if you quit reading the Enquirer.
Look at this. Over the top, Morocco down in front. Goes Mr. Wonderful, nice soundtrack, caught him coming in, and another one. Morocco got outsmarted.
I don't think so. Look at how fast he went up to his feet. And the referee is on the ball, too.
Right in there. Make sure the right guy stays in and the wrong guy gets out. That's most important. Look at Fuji with that cane. Talk about distraction.
He is a vicious human being in his own right, too, you know. You ever hear him laugh? It sounds like somebody's putting thumb screws on him and just tightening and tightening. It's hard. It's vicious.
Mr. Wonderful on the receiving end. Look at this. Scotty didn't want to waste any more time. He saw Mr. Wonderful get the number done on him, so he came in immediately, and now all four men in the ring.
Well, obviously the referee has lost it right now, but what are you going to do with the magnificent one and Paul Orndorff in that ring?
Look at this. Wow, they were thrown off at the last moment.
And outsmarted.
Scotty McGee really took the brunt of that blow.
You can tell that Morocco's the general in that ring right now.
Look out. Both men double teamed to the corner. Oh, look at this. Mr. Wonderful using his partner to good advantage. And still all four men in the ring. Pandemonium broken loose here this week.
You think as good as he says, he couldn't have done that by himself.
Well, two against two makes it fair. Mm-hmm. Look at Spotty. He's not too happy about what's happening. And neither is Mr. Fuji for that matter. Talk about your tremendous tag team competition. We certainly have it with us this week. I'd like to see this in a single matchup right here.
That would be something, wouldn't it?
Yes, it would.
I bet you a magnificent one would want it too.
With possibly you as the guest referee.
Oh, wouldn't that be something?
Yeah. Orndorff got out of there. Young Scotty McGee tagged in, and now Spotty's tagged in. Spotty and Scotty going to have trouble keeping them apart now.
Oh, you're a poet. You don't know it.
Yes. Oh, look at that backbreaker. Bulldog Spot can do that as well as anyone. Look out below. Wow.
Got the shoulder.
Morocco says, let me have him. And Morocco, so deliberate in every one of his moves, he doesn't waste any energy.
No. That's a professional and a champion, such as himself.
Former Intercontinental Heavyweight Champion.
Yes. Two times, I believe.
Took the title away from Pat Patterson.
Pat Patterson?
Yes. Pedro Morales.
Yeah, Madison Square Garden.
Pat Patterson was the first one to hold the coveted title. Won it in Rio de Janeiro, South America.
Did he really?
Yeah.
That's the Lego.
Scotty, not faring too well right now. This is the time to get over and make the tag. That's what tag team wrestling is all about.
He's paying his dues, too.
Oh, look at that clothesline.
The kid is tough. I have to admit, he is tough.
He's a comer.
Good looking, too.
Oh. There it is. There's a tag made. Mr. Wonderful off the top rope with an elbow. A big right hand. And one for the Moondog. He's on fire. Morocco is stunned.
Morocco's got a plan.
Oh, nice reversal. Watch out. Oh, perfect.
Inside neckbreaker. Come on, Donald. Donald, get up, Donald.
Morocco, Donald out of it.
Oh, look at these idiots screaming for no reason at all.
Here comes the pile driver. He's trying to get him up now. Here comes Spotty. And look at Mr. Fuji. He was about to climb it down.
I think he was a decoy.
Morocco was in deep trouble there and about to have the pile driver applied to him.
Almost only.
Wow. What a clothesline. Two count. He got him.
I guess it's a lucky day.
Obviously, he caught Moondog's spot right on the magic button as he knocked him right down and out. And look at this. Morocco, not too happy. It'll go down in the record books as a loss. Let's get your
the winners of this bout, Scott McGee and Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff.
Well, that means the loser, Don Morocco.
No.
Yes. Let's go back and take a look at how Mr. Wonderful polished off Spotty. Things going his way right here, eh? But watch how quick the tables can turn.
Yes,
look at this out of nowhere. Oh, right on a button. Down for the easy 1-2-3 count. And look at Scotty coming in to make sure that Morocco doesn't interfere. Don't go away, wrestling fans. An interview coming up.